Welcome, friends. It is I, Rez Scarf, and it's time for the vlog. And in the background is going to be Nezha. Yep, Nezha Jungle, I think it is. Now, this is going to be a very, very, very interesting vlog. You're going to see how you win, despite being down in kills and in gold. At the end of this vlog, I'll explain it, because it'll be closer to the end. But right now, just watch this. This is a very curious game. You're going to see a lot of feeding going on, but you're going to see how a team that is losing the entire game can win a game. And it's ridiculous. Now, as far as things go, Scotty and Welcome Back Cotter are coming out soon. They'll be out on Tuesday. And so Tuesday night and Wednesday night, I'm going to try to stream so I can get some footage of them, because I'm going to be gone this next week. I'm going to be gone Thursday to Sunday to Vegas. And that should be a lot of fun. It was an unexpected trip to go on, so I'm just hard at work getting a lot of work done so that we're not behind on anything while I'm gone. And so, stressful time right now, stressful time. Future stuff coming up, some pretty good Smite games. As you noticed, we're doing 3 a week now. It's just to relieve some pressure. And because, like I said last week, I'm not having as much fun, so just trying to play Smite a little bit less. Focus more on guides as well, though. I'm going to try to get a guide every week. Nezha guide is nearly finished for tomorrow. I'm going to get to work on Neith guide after Nezha. And then it'll be Nox guide after that. So I'm getting to work on those things to make sure they get done every week. That way it's not like every 2 weeks. I'm just getting done every week. I don't know when I'm going to do Machinima. I want to do Machinima a month, but I'm just really... That Spectator is such a pain in the ass to work with. It just makes Machinimas not even worth doing. I just wish it was better. I really do. I wish it was so much better, but it's not. Scotty and Kadir look pretty cool. Well, literally cool. Definitely would tap that. Probably should have said that, but I would. I'd be okay getting frozen to her. I'd have no problem. No problem. That's gotta be painful, though. But, okay, if I remember correctly, lore-wise, she's married to another dude, divorces him for whatever reason in Norse mythology, and then she gets with Uller. So I'm expecting some conversation between her and Uller. Maybe either flirtatious stuff, because they might go with them before they're married, or after they're married, so there's like, honey, why are you shooting me? Honey, why are you attacking me? Oh crap, her dog's kicking my ass now. I look like I'm in the doghouse with Kadir now, because I accidentally killed her right here. Something funny I'm hoping for. That would be funny though, I'm in the doghouse with Kadir. With Cotter, because he shot her down. That'd be great, because they're both hunters. Although, the sense I'm getting is she's more of a solo hunter than a duo hunter, so that's pretty curious right there. And they had to fix some bugs, because apparently melees were not working on Kadir, or Cotter, so that's interesting. She's got an interesting kit to her, it's very curious. I don't know where she's going to be on the spectrum. Last couple of guides have been ridiculous. I don't know where she'd be until I actually play her. Like, PTS isn't enough to really get a good sense. It's enough to see if something's stupid. PTS is enough to see if something's stupid. Like Medusa Poison in PTS. Like Bologna in PTS, like Nemesis, like, you get a good sense of something if it's stupid from PTS. But if you want to get the full flavor, the full idea, you gotta wait until actual, actual release, because they're gonna make some little tweaks, hopefully. And you actually get to see it against, people who are actually playing and not just people just doing the PTS, because people do PTS will do some silly stuff just to check if something's not working or stuff like that. You'll see that. Let's see here, other things. A lot of one-shots coming up, gonna be really good. We have a lot of recent games, so there's gonna be a lot of recent game one-shots. I've been playing a lot of Flame the Flood during streams, as far as the music goes, so that's a good indication that there's gonna be a one-shot of that coming out. Other recent games are also gonna have one-shots as well. There's gonna be some also past games coming up. But a lot of recent stuff right here. I can't wait for you guys to see those. Those are pretty entertaining one-shots, I think. And also, just good information there, and I recommend pretty much the majority of my one-shots are recommended games. Some of them are for other reasons, but the majority are recommended games. Like, sometimes it's a, well, viewer donated, and I want to check it out, let's see it. And it's like, okay, this isn't so great, and I'll say why. It gives me a chance to just say things about design. It's like, the designs here not bad, but it could have been better in different ways. So it becomes an interesting kind of other thing. And another review is coming up, and that'll be the Flame of the Flood one. Firewatch is done. Sunday or Monday will be the afterthoughts. It'll be a recording where it's just me saying what I thought from everything and also things in reflection. Firewatch was an intense game. It's a very compelling game. If you haven't checked out that LP, good time to do it because it's all done now. You can see the story of it. It's a really good story. That was a heck of a game. It was very good. Really liked it. Upcoming LP? Hitman. Hitman is coming, everybody. And here's some good news. I have a free copy of the entire game, the full experience, not the $15 version, the $60 version of Hitman. The first week that game comes out, the LP comes out, I'm going to have it that if you leave a comment each day, we'll give you a chance at winning that full copy. That's what's going to be there. It's going to be kind of like the Christmas thing where each day, if you make a comment, you have a chance. So tell your friends as well so they have a chance as well. Everyone get a chance to win the full version of Hitman. And I'm enjoying Hitman a lot. There are some things here and there about Hitman that are not as great, but there are things about it that are better. And I feel like overall it's really good, but my problem with Hitman is that it's episodic. My problem with it is it feels unfinished story-wise because they're doing it in episodes. So it's a fun experience, but also kind of just disappointing in that I can't see the full story and it's going to take the whole year to see it because of the way they're doing it. Right now we got the base game with contracts mode, some other interesting modes. You get the prologue and the first level. The second level comes out in April, third level comes out in May, and so on until you get the final seventh level near the end of the year. And it's an interesting idea, but at the same time I feel like it's a weak-ass idea, because by doing it that way, yeah, you're keeping it relevant to people's minds over the year, but you're also just blueballing people. Because I really want to see how this story goes, because I actually care about the lore of Hitman. I care about the things, like, how he affects the world, because they've always had that, like, how does the Hitman affect the world in a way by doing all these high-profile hits? And so I just want to see the next part of the story. And it just does not build well on itself one episode at a time for that. It's very unfortunate because there's just not enough there to make you go, I can't wait for the next episode. Gameplay-wise, you can't wait because you really want to play next level. Because Hitman's a very enjoyable game. But story-wise, it's just like, oh great, so we just got another piece. Now we got to wait a while for the next piece. And it's very unfortunate. It really is. I'm just a little disappointed with that. But overall, it is a great game. Very fun. I'm thankful to Square Enix for giving us a free copy of the game. I'm thankful to them for that. So yeah, Scarf is coming up a little bit bigger now. We're getting free copies here and there. We're getting better at exposure. We're getting better, and we're getting out there a little bit more. We're getting free copies of things. By the way, another thing, we got to work on the one-shot for Vermintide for the new DLC. We got free DLC for it, so we got the new the Last Stand map for Vermintide, very fun game. We're gonna do a one-shot showing off that mode, and they gave us two free copies of Vermintide, of the game itself. Two free copies, they're gonna give away those through that one-shot as well. We're getting free copies of things! This is awesome! We're able to give away things because developers are giving us things. We're slowly making it a little bit, like, these are little rare occurrences here and there, but when we're able to make it a normal thing, instead of just every once in a while a developer just throws us something, then we're really making good progress there. That's great. So we're doing better making some headway with developers in a way, which is really great, and I'm happy about that. That's cool right there. We're getting better with some connections. So we're doing better there. Unfortunately, we are dipping in Patreon. Like, we've lost a couple patrons, which is just too bad, and that's because I don't know. I think people lose interest over time. People gain interest over time here and there. We do a little bit of bonus things for Patreon here and there as well. But everything at the end of the day goes to the YouTube, so you get everything there. So we don't really do a lot of Patreon exclusives. But it's not about Patreon exclusives. It's about getting supported so that we can do more. Like, because of Patreon, we've been able to cover a AAA game every month. It's because of Patreon. Because we make enough money off that to do that. It's because of Patreon we were able to get that NVIDIA card, that really nice card we have now, so that we can do even stronger games. Our hardware upgrades are because of the Patreon. We're able to afford things because of that. Unfortunately, we're dipping down now, which is just too bad, so we gotta work on that, and we'll probably work on that. We'll do little things here and there, but probably the biggest push for that will be later on. Right now, it's just mentioning here and there if you guys want to support. We have a Patreon, there you go. Pushing Patreon in a big way is something that a lot of content creators do feel iffy about. It's like, well, we don't really want to ask for money directly because, well, you know, you just, it's an iffy thing asking for money directly. And so even for us, it is an iffy thing. We're like, with donations, we can do more. And so we do more. But it's also like trying to get money out of it and just, you don't really know. You're not really too sure about it. In that, you know, it's asking for money. But the realization is, money's important because it allows you to do things. If not for the Patreon money, we would not have this better card. We would not have better hardware to get things done. It's because of Patreon we're able to do that. Because of Patreon we're able to afford AAA titles so that we can play them and show them off to the viewers so that they can have a lot of fun with that. And so, yeah, Patreon is pretty important. It's just an important part of everything. And we just, I think it's just because we're just very shy about it that Patreon just is not doing as well as it could. And we got to work on that. We definitely have to work on that. There's a lot of things we got to work on. I feel like we're getting stronger in a lot of ways. The guides have gotten are just really strong right now. I'm really happy with my ability to make them as short as they are while giving a lot of information. I was really happy to hear from Medusa people that they learned some things from that. People who played it regularly, I'm like, that means I'm doing a good job with this. I'm happy with that. So I'm really trying to make sure I get one out every week so I get better at the guides so that they come out short but strong, and that'd be really good right there. I think my Smite games are pretty good. Like, they're pretty entertaining. Like, people love the hell out of the Odin game. There's another one coming out in a couple weeks at some point, I'm sure, because I'm going to keep playing Odin. Than is going to happen. We got the Death Scythe Than. Like, there's going to be videos. There's going to be a good amount of really strong Smite videos coming out. I think my LPs are pretty good. Firewatch was a hell of a thing. It was more Firewatch than me, though, because that story, it just takes you. The Hitman LP, the way this is going to go, the first half of it is going to be very entertaining in how I bungle my way through it, because when you first play a Hitman game, you're feeling the game out and trying to figure things out, and you usually make a lot of sloppy mistakes, and it's pretty hilarious how the sloppy mistakes go. The second half of this LP is going to be more professional run stuff, like going for the perfect run. And so you'll see both sides. You'll see sloppily bungling through it and just making a lot of mistakes, but somehow pulling it off anyway, which is hilarious. And then you'll see the more professional way of how do you perfectly run a thing just so you have that side of it as well. Because that's how Hitman is. When you're first playing it, you don't do so great. And then later on, you're trying to get that perfect run. And it's a puzzle. The puzzle of each level of how do you get the perfect run? And I'm going to try to find those and get them out for the second half of the LP. And then what's going to happen is we're going to put down Hitman for a while. Like, we're going to do Hitman for a while, then we're going to put it down, do some other LP, and then come back to Hitman later on when the new content comes out. We're going to probably do that throughout the year because of how Hitman's working. And so we'll see how that goes. And we'll see what other LP we do at the same time. So that's going to be pretty interesting. And yeah. What else is there to talk about? I don't remember if I mentioned this. The highlights, they're not going to come out every week unless we get a lot of good highlights. You'll see the newest one, it's only 2 minutes long. Because there's no Fallout highlights to put in there to make it longer, so they might come out every 2 weeks or however, depending on how many highlights we get. And that's when it'll come out, just so that they're not just 2 minutes long, that they're pretty good highlight videos. So we'll see about that. We'll see how Hitman adds to that. I really think Hitman will add to the highlight reel pretty well, in my opinion, because I had fun with this. I really did. It's kind of fun failing and making ridiculous things happen. That's always been a fun thing about Hitman, is just you can make some ridiculous things happen, despite how kind of serious the game is. There is a little bit of humor to it as well. It's very curious. What else is there? I don't know what else to say. We've been at this for about like 3.5 years at this point. We've tried very hard to be very professional about the channel and making a lot of content and just always improving. And we have improved a lot over the years, and we're still improving. We're doing a lot better. But we could always improve in a lot of ways. I think the one place where we could really improve the most would be networking and talking to people and just selling ourselves better. And again, I already talked about that earlier with Patreon. We're not selling ourselves as well as we could because, well, we're just not. This is the thing about any art. Like, you'll see that with artists more than anything, but content creators are the kind of same thing. Like, anyone who makes anything, makers. You make good stuff, people really like your stuff, but you yourself, you see the flaws and you don't think of it as great as ever other people do, which allows you to get better, but also you undersell things. And I do think we are underselling ourselves a bit, and there are bigger projects we can do that we can't do right now, but there's things we could do to do even better, or we could sell things even better, but we just aren't selling them as well. One example is the Patreon. We're not selling the Patreon as well as we could. Like, I think we're really good, and maybe we should be selling, but we just aren't selling the Patreon very well. And another one is just getting out there to developers and just saying, hey, we're a channel. We got 10,000 subs now. We can get you about 100 views with the one-shots, which isn't a big number, but we do have a pretty good base that really likes to watch things like this. And some of them do buy games. Like, I got to get out there a little bit more with that. And just talking to just other creators and stuff like that. Like, it's it is not an easy thing for me. Like, we're pretty shy at networking, so it's something to work on. It's selling ourselves something we really got to work on. And I just got to work on that. I have no idea how I'm going to work on it, though. It's a hard thing to do. Like, we're both introverts. Like, I'm an extroverted introvert because we do this thing. But at the end of the day, I am an introvert. So it's hard to network out. But we got to work on that. I can only use that excuse so much. But yeah, just got to work on that. You guys hear these vlogs, you hear the status of things and how we feel we need to improve on things. Yeah, we definitely need to improve. By the way, yeah, we hit 10,000 subs. It's at 10,000 subs this week. Hooray. We really need to do a celebration video for that. And I don't know when, because Jinx has like a lot of tests and assignments and work and all that stuff. And I've got things as well. My back and other things like that. Just, sometimes you get too damn busy. I keep saying it, and I think like the summer is where things are going to blow up, because that's when I graduate, and we'll see how things go there, and then Jinx will have the summer off, I think, because, well, summer, so you don't have school at summer, so we'll see how things go at that point. We'll see how we evolve, how we change, how things develop, but that doesn't mean we shouldn't be trying to improve in different ways on the before we get there, and of course we are trying to improve. But yeah, that's what's going on. There's some big topics I could talk about. We're not going to talk about them yet. I don't know when I'll talk about them, because they can always happen at any time. It's very universal things I usually try to talk about. I do want to talk about some things, but not yet. Keep this short. Got a lot of things I need to work on. So the Nezha game. You're seeing the Nezha game, right? So I'm not sure how deep this is in there, because I try not to play the video at the same time as doing these, because if I do that, I'll get a bit distracted by the game. I've done that before. But you'll see in this game, I'm getting kills, and Soul is getting objectives. The other three members of the team are doing okay. They're feeding, but they're doing okay. A lot of the work is me and Soul in this match. We're doing our best. Everyone's doing their best, but it's a lot of me trying to get kills or stall the enemy out. My teammates are doing okay. Later in the match, they do a lot better, though, but it is a lot of me and Soul doing work and Soul taking out objectives. And what you see is the enemy team is focusing too much on kills, overcompensating, over-rotating, allowing Soul to just take structures. He just keeps taking things away from them. And this is the lesson of kills are important. They will win you. They will help you win the game. But objectives are how you win the game. If you don't take advantage of your kills to win the game, you're gonna lose. And because the enemy overcompensates too much, they're constantly just giving Soul room to do what she needs to do. And I'm doing my best to tie up the enemy team. We win the game, despite the fact they have double the kills we have, and they have more gold than us by the end of the match. That's what happens there. Another thing is a note on the enemy. Baka is, he starts backdooring with his ultimate, which is the right thing to do with Baka, but he does it too late. Like, when he finally does it, we're about to win the game. Like, he finally does it just too late, and we're going to win the game. That's what happens there. I don't know if that's happened yet, but that's what happens in this match. And you're going to get a little bit from me at the end there, where I'm talking to the Baka, where I'm like, because Baka says Soul too easy or something like that, how Soul's OP. I'm like, no. That's not it. Couple problems. One, they played Baka in solo, which is getting dominated by warriors right now, and mages are going to do better than Baka there. Soul does better than Baka. He climbs back up pretty well through jungle and through roaming. He doesn't do it well in the solo lane. He gets it from being very active in other places. Him in solo is just not very good for him. I like him better in jungle. And the other is Soul's not OP. Soul is annoying as hell to deal with, but the reason why we won with Soul and her taking out towers is because they let her. They left the door open for her. They kept over-rotating to other places, leaving her open to do a thing. It's like dealing with Loki. You never let Loki backdoor. You don't leave an opening like that. You never fully commit to let Loki do that. You always have a presence. Like, you can have five somewhere as long as somebody has the ability to teleport to a tower to stop Loki, or go back to base to stop him at Phoenix. You always have something ready to stop Loki if you're going to go for a big rotation. That's the same thing for Soul. She's able to do that. Who else can do that? Bastet can do that. Anyone who can split push or backdoor, you always have something ready in case they try to do that. The enemy team in this game had nothing to stop Soul, and they deserve to lose because of that. It'd be the same thing if we didn't have Soul, if we had Loki. There's no real excuse there. Soul being too strong is not it. It's that you did not have the right tools to stop her. You did not use the right tools to stop her, I mean. Any team can stop Soul if they know what the hell they're doing. This team did not, and they lost, and they deserve to lose for that reason. Just like we deserve to lose whenever we let something like that happen. Whenever we let a Soul go rampant. Whenever we let a Loki backdoor. Or a Bastet or a Baka backdoor. We let them do that, We deserve to lose because we were not keeping tight control of the map. That's what it is. You lose by objectives, it's your own fault if you do not keep control of that. Especially if you're over-rotating. Now, if you're just making little mistakes or just little heartbreaks, then fine. Like, you almost had it, but you just blew it by a little bit. That's fine. That's just the game going. But if you just make these big mistakes, these big over-moves, these, like, overextending moves, that's your own fault. It's no one else's fault. So at the end of the game, I'm like, look, you had more kills than us. You had more gold than us. You should have won this game. Chew on that fact. Chew on that fact, Baka. You should have won this game. And it isn't me reacting to just someone just talking crap at the end of a match. I usually just ignore it, but I couldn't ignore it on this one because this is a holy crap we won by these means, and also because it's a Baka saying it. Baka is one of my favorite gods in the game. If a Baka player is talking crap, I'm gonna give it to them because they deserve it. That's how I feel about it. I'm not taking the higher ground when it's something I really care about. So there you go, that is the vlog. I'll probably record a vlog Wednesday night for Saturday, or there will be no vlog next week. I want there to be a vlog. I like having a vlog every week, but we'll see if I have anything to talk about. If I don't have anything to talk about, then there's no vlog. There you go. Things will go as scheduled as normal. While I'm in Vegas, we will release the Neath guide, so that'll still be going on. I will have internet access up there, so I'll be able to put it out there. I just won't be able to do as actively as I could if I was at home. So that's going to happen there. I'm going to try to get... So Nezha guide's going to be done and ready later today for tomorrow. I'm going to try to get Neath guide done before I leave. And if I can get Nox, at least the groundwork done for Nox before I leave as well, that'd be really good. Because then I can just get it done at some point before she comes out. That'd be great. After Nox, I can't remember who's after Nox. Skip Mercury because he's already got a guide. Skip Nox. I mean, skip Nemesis because no. No. Whoever comes after Nox, they're going to get a guide as well. I'm just going to get all these guides out. I'm going to try to get all these guides out. And then we'll go to the gods I skipped and go like, okay, here's how you can play them. And there you go. Not really beginner, not really advanced guide. It's more of a, here's what you need to know to be able to play these gods kind of guides. Because I don't want to say advanced because then that'll be, then no beginners will want to try them at all. And it's really, you don't want beginners to try these guides who I feel are just not good for beginners, but ones you can branch into. Not saying they're advanced, but ones that you can branch into after you've played the game for a while. Like, Kali is not a god for beginners. She is not. She's not even intermediate, not even advanced. She is just this god. Like, any god who's not beginner is someone you can play later. You do not play them at the start because you're going to feed all day, is really what I'm saying, if they're not a beginner god, in my opinion. So, okay, there you go. That right there is the vlog. I had fun making it. I hope you for watching it. That's what's all about, isn't it? Had a fun links come by, and see you next time. And of course, thank you everyone for your likes and subs and spreading the word. Thank you to Jinx for all of her hard work. We could easily get to 20k by the end of this year if we spread the word. It'd be really good. So please spread the word where you can. We'll spread the word where we can. We'll try to improve, make things even better, more amazing, so that people will notice us. But it takes all of us. So thanks for everything, everybody. See you later.
Under attack.
An ally has been slain. Teammates are killing.
On my way.
An enemy has been smoked.
Double bubble. Toiling chatter.
Look at him. Thanks. You at night. Let's go.
You did a thing.
You rock.
Dad, you're in. Get yourself together, girl.
right tower.
No worries.
To destroy. Your team has destroyed the left enemy tower.
Attack left lane!
Stop right there! Attack!
On my way!
Destroy the left enemy.
Retreat!
Don't you even feel a little bit bad?
Off you go.
Yummy! Make it burn!
No, I will estimate you. That not happen.
An ally has been slain. How much do you think the enemy team is paying them? Teammate did a thing. You have been slain. Stop breaking things. Someone's gonna make
it. Yeah,
really?
Good.
Only a double
that
kill?
Not bad.
Come on.
Ha! Break it down!
An enemy has been slain.
You are so good!
Enemy ultimate incoming!
Retreat!
Enemy ultimate down!
Okay.
Watch the curve!
A little unstable.
I'll defend middle lane!
Okay.
Yes!
Okay!
Died.
Your team has destroyed
a lot. Now I'm angry.
slain.
It burns.
Get up there.
Nice job. Stop.
Attack the right Phoenix.
Watch out there.
On my way. Be careful.
Take it right.
Your middle Phoenix is under attack.
Now
you killed a guy. Your middle Phoenix has been destroyed.
Defend the Titan!
Yes!
Cancel that.
Enemy missing!
No worries!
Good game!